Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. In the late 1960s, rock music exploded with psychedelic art. I'm going to show you how to recreate this famous poster from 1967 by Victor Mascasa. I provided this Photoshop template that you can download. Its link is in my video's description or project files. It includes two layers. The bottom layer is the original poster from 1967, including the three colors that we used in this poster. The top layer is a photo that we'll use for this project. Feel free to use your own photo if you'd like. I also included the bottom layer as a separate document that will open later, which will make it easier for us to change the colors of our poster. In addition, I provided a link to this typeface that's similar to the one used in the original poster. The first step is to make selections of the sunglass lenses. Make sure your photo is active and open the zoom tool. Drag it over the lenses. Open your quick selection tool and make its size approximately 10 pixels. Make sure the add selection icon is active. This will allow us to make selections for both of the lenses. Drag the tool over the inside of one of the lenses to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. We'll smooth it out in a moment. Go to the other lens and make a selection over it. To check it, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. To revert it back into a selection, press Q again. Go to Select, Modify, and Smooth. Let's smooth it 50 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Now, when we convert it into a quick mask, we can see that our selection is smoothed out significantly. Then press Q again. Go to Select and Save Selection. Just click OK. We'll use this selection later. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Zoom back out by pressing Ctrl or Command 0 to fill your canvas with a document. To zoom out even more, press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard. We'll convert our photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Next, we'll make our photo into a black and white halftone. But before we do, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. If they're inverted, press X. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Halftone Pattern. Make the size 3, the contrast 25, and the pattern type dot. Open the Swatches image I provided. Go to its tab and drag it out. If you want to make it smaller, press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard to zoom out. Then go to a corner and drag the window in to hug the image. Place your cursor anywhere outside the Swatches document and click it to activate your poster document. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Gradient Map. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the left stop and the color box. When the color picker opens, click the red box in the swatch image to pick up its color. Then click OK on the color picker. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and click the orange box in the swatch image. Click OK on both windows to close them, or you can press Enter or Return twice. Make a new layer. We'll place it into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Ctrl or Command click the thumbnail of Alpha 1 to select its shape. Open back the Layers panel and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the folder. Click the chain link to unlink the layer mask with the folder. Doing this allows us to reposition and resize any layers in the folder independent of the layer mask. Make the empty layer active and click your foreground color. Click the blue swatch to pick up its color and click OK on the color picker. We'll fill the empty layer with the foreground color by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. The reason the color is confined to the inside of the sunglasses is because the black area of the layer mask is masking it out. Next, we'll create the border. Make a new layer. We'll place it at the top of the Layers panel by either dragging it manually to the top or by pressing Ctrl or Command and the right bracket key on our keyboard. We'll fill it with any color. The color itself is irrelevant. I'll fill it with white, and since my background color is white, I'll press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Reduce the fill to zero. This makes the inside of the layer invisible, but it'll retain all the layer styles that we'll be adding to it. Double-click the layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. Click the color box, and click the red swatch. Then click OK. Make its size 32 pixels, and the position inside. Click Inner Glow, the color box, and the blue swatch. Then click OK. The blend mode is normal, the opacity is 100%, and the noise is zero. The technique is irrelevant in this case. The source is edge, the choke is 100%, and the size is 50 pixels. The contour is linear, and the range is 50%. Next, we'll add text inside the sunglasses. Let's collapse the layer styles to save a bit of space in the Layers panel. Hide the blue color inside the lenses so we can see the text that we initially type out. Make the blue layer active and make a new layer above it. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. After you install the text I provided, open it. For now, make its size large enough for you to see it. The aliasing is smooth and make it flush right if you're typing out more than one line of text. Click inside the left lens and type out your text. To adjust its size, highlight the text and place your cursor over the text size icon. When your cursor changes into a scrubby slider, drag it to the right or left. Make it any size you like. Next, we'll make a red stroke around the text. Double-click an empty area of the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Stroke. The color should still be red. The position is outside, and the size is 12 pixels. Make a copy of the text by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag the copy over the right lens. Holding Shift kept our text perfectly aligned. Next, we'll warp our text to conform to the inside of the shape of the lenses, but before we do, we'll convert each of the text layers into a smart object. Hide the top text and open your transform tool. Click the warp transform icon and drag the anchor points to warp sections of the text. Feel free to warp it in any shape you want. If you want to see it over the blue background inside the lens, click the check mark at the top and make the blue background visible. Open your transform tool again and click the warp transform icon. Continue to drag anchor points and other areas of the transform to a shape you like. Then press Enter or Return. Make the other text layer visible and double-click it to open its original text. Double-click the large T of the layer to highlight the text and type out your new text. If you need more room, go to Image and Canvas Size. For its width, I'll type in 1,000 pixels and press Enter or Return. Double-click the large T of the text layer to highlight the text and drag the scrubby slider over the text size icon to the left to reduce its size. Then, click the check mark. Go to Image and Trim. Tick Transparent Pixels and trim away all four corners. Close the .psb file, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Notice our text in the right lens has been updated. Open your Transform tool, adjust its size and position, click the Warp Transform icon again, and warp the text. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.